payday, you trolls.
Maybe I'll buy me a kettle, boil up some rat shit.
Save me seconds, love.
Hey, Princess, you got kettles for sale or not? Princess, she got spunk in her ear.
Save me seconds.
These kettles are 3 shillings. I'll be right back. If something's missing, I'll know.
Why look at me, eh? Why look at me? Hey!
Bitch.
Don't ruffle her feathers, Hest. It's her cat.
You ever wonder how that is? She didn't come to camp but 5 months ago and she weren't no peddler then.
Answer's right there. Young Major Talmadge.
You said she was yoked to some fat cull in Philadelphia.
Says the scuttlebutt. She don't act married now, does she?
Tell me something good, Leah.
Word is Peterson's willing to pump 20 billion into Unitel to put them on top again. But only with a real turnaround pro at the helm.
That sounds like a perfect fit for a certain lucky someone. Not too bad he won't take a meeting.
Well, maybe not with a notorious corporate headhunter.
You know something I don't?
I know where he'll be in 30 minutes. Remember that cute Irish pub in Camden Lock?
I forget. How do you know he'll be there?
Because he's about to be stood up by his Tinder date. And since her photo makes her look like a former Russian supermodel instead of some overworked finance scribe, odds are he'll be primed for some scotch and sympathy.
Catfished him, you bad girl.
I am a bad girl. And if you land this whale, you owe me an exclusive. You very bad boy.
What do you suppose them two gob about?
God knows. But that's the girl brought poor Andre his red coats who he got hanging it.
Andre?
Didn't see him hanged. But I did see him hung, if you catch my meaning, eh?
No one says jet setting anymore. You feel like I stepped out of an episode of Mad Men.
Never watched it.
I thought that's all you and Fred did. Watch TV shows every night.
No, and that's your idea of what we do, because our oh-so-conventional lives must be oh-so-conventionally boring.
Aren't they?
There's nothing predictable or boring about raising a family.
I mean, however hard that is for you to hear. Wiping up snot and poop 24/7? Never saw the attraction.
Why am I even talking to you?
Because I'm your glamorous, jet-setting older sister. And some part of you wishes you made the same choice I did.
Put the gun down.
You know how hard can it be to get food? Or clothes? Proper uniforms? My Jeb's been using his socks for gloves.
Oh, wait a moment. I bet you could use this. For one pair of gloves with a bit of needlecraft.
And I have the needle and the craft.
And you got enough beaver pelts for the rest of his company?
Shh.
Lady Washington. Isn't she kind to grace us with her company before she goes back up to her plantation to be tended by all her servants?
Mrs. Washington strikes me as a woman with a good heart.
Oh, of course, you'd like her.
Carney, laundry.
You do it. I'm through washing clothes for officers when men like my husband can barely keep warm.
This is Captain Williams' coat.
I'm not in your army, so I don't take your orders, you gotch-gutted bugger.
I'll do it, Corporal.
She'll do it.
Maybe you could ask Lady Washington to do the load. I ain't touching a rag.
Hi, guys. My name's Miss Blackburn. And I'll be taking over Miss Spatman's classes until she returns back from her cold.
I think I'm up to speed with the maths and the science, but is there anything else I need to know?
Oh, yes. We're doing a friendship project at the moment. Unfortunately, my friendship project partner is ill.
Right then, who's up next? Hello, Ricky.
The way she moves is like a river. It's just beautiful. This is to you, Miss Blackburn. Jetta M.
Well, thank you, Ricky.
Mrs. Carney, I'm sorry for the intrusion, but I heard your baby crying.
and you're the helpful type, I know. Sorry I don't have no tea to offer you. A little different out here than cuddling with your darling Major, ain't it?
I understand your anger. But I've also heard of another woman who refused to work and was drummed out. And now I see you have a child.
So?
So, for all its problems, this camp is a safer place for a family than what's outside. So, yes, I'd like to help. With laundry or anything else they ask you to do.
What about a sutler's cart?
I'll ask someone else to mind it.
You don't much like me, do you? Well, I certainly ain't no fine lady. But I ain't no officer's mole, neither. I know what ain't fair and what ain't right. I won't lay down for those bastards, no matter how they plan to arm me.